The number one question I've been getting lately about Destiny 2 is surprisingly from lapsed players or new players who are looking to get into the game. If I want to get back into Destiny, where do I begin? Now, the long and the short of it is that there's not really anything you can do that's wrong in terms of playing the game, especially when you're a lower level. To put it simply, if you do anything, you're going to level up. So if you like PvP, play some PvP. If you like the story, check out the menu to see if you have any story quests available. If you want to know what's been going on, that's going to be the easiest place to start. With that said, here are a few tips and things you may want to consider trying first if you're just coming back.
In my opinion, now would be an amazing time to come back and at least play through the story content you're behind on. Come September, the map is going to dramatically change and a ton of the content currently available is going into what Bungie calls the Destiny Content Vault. This means that any mission on Titan, Mars, Mercury, Io, and all activities on Leviathan are going away. So you only have until September 2020 to play some of this content. They specifically pointed out that this includes the raids and campaigns that take place on those destinations. Only three of the raids will be playable this fall, one of which is the Deepstone Crypt on Europa. Exotics are going to be given new ways to be earned, so this season is the only one where you can get those from the known current destinations. It might be easier to get them in future seasons, or even more difficult. And Gambit and Gambit Prime are being merged into one mode. If you've been waiting to play anything, the fact that the entire game is going to be changing is the main reason I think you should consider starting in this current season. Even if you don't get to this season's content and you're just leveling up, it would be a great time to get caught up and be ready for the big expansion this fall. If you haven't heard yet, Beyond Light is going to take place on the ice planet Europa and introduce new powers of darkness. The best part about the season we're in right now is that each week there is a story mission that's going to tie directly into the story told this fall. Because there will be a new raid, jumping in now gives you access to all the content you've missed and sets you up for what's looking like a great expansion this fall. Exotics like the Stranger's Pulse Rifle and Hawkmoon will also be returning in that new expansion. Destiny 2 is going to become a single evolving world, and this fall that goes into full effect. So if you want to replay any of the older content, stop by Amanda Holiday for the campaign missions that are likely going away. So I think most people realize that yes, you can play story missions, but I think what you're really asking is, how in the hell do I level up? So let's talk about leveling, and if you're not into that, check the description for time codes of other useful sections of this video. Well, I said you can't do anything wrong, and that's true. If you're above 1,000 power, there is an ideal method to leveling. Everything below 1010, the method is just to throw on whatever the highest powerful item is and do what you want with the rest. After 1010, you'll want to do your powerful engrams, tier 1, 2, and 3, before you do your pinnacle engrams. You can see which activity rewards each type, as they have an icon in the corner and text when you hover over it, telling you what type of rewards it has. There are a ton of places to do this, so you can start wherever you like and go from there. Just remember to start at tier 1 to 3 before moving on to pinnacle drops. Pinnacles are always going to get you to the highest power in the game. They come from missions like raids, dungeons, the Nightfall, and have been expanded into other activities like Vanguard Strikes. They give you the biggest boost, and once you're at 1050 power, they're the only way for you to advance through the power ranks. Oh, and just a small note, but if you ever get one piece of gear that just won't drop, check out vendorengrams.xyz to see what's dropping at your level. If you turn in tokens at them, you can often get lucky and get that one drop you need to bump you into the next tier. Or you can just pull it from your season pass to keep climbing. So now that you've got a rundown on the basics of leveling, let's talk about the season we're on. In season 11, everything is focused around the pyramid showing up. If you like story and haven't played through Shadowkeep, I highly recommend starting there. There were a lot of stories you won't want to miss in Forsaken, but if you want to jump ahead and get caught up, play through Shadowkeep, and then hop into this season's new story mission. I won't go into spoilers, but I will say that I'm really digging what they're teasing for the future of Destiny 2.
Weapons and armor-wise, if there are any exotics you need to get, be sure to Google where Xur appears every Friday. He always has a nice selection of exotics to buy, and he also sells a faded engram that is guaranteed to unlock something you haven't acquired yet. You can only get one per account per week, so be sure to open it on a character you need the piece of gear you're chasing. There are some exotics behind raid activities like Anarchy and 1000 Voices, which I highly recommend getting. Each has recently had their drop rates increased, and there's still an LFG or two out there willing to take you through the activity for your chance at each. There are a few exotic quests, including Whisper of the Worm and Outbreak Prime, both you should definitely grab if you have the time. On the legendary front, Season 11 is a really interesting time to get started. There are a ton of legendaries out there you can acquire, but because Bungie has been so open with their roadmap, we know that most are going to be retired. So you know all those legendary quests? I wouldn't recommend working on them, because in a few months, they'll be outdated. Instead, I would keep an eye on the max power for each weapon you acquire. If it's above 1060, you know that it's going to last a bit longer than other weapons, and in Season 11, the weapons you'll be able to use the longest are those that have a maximum power of 1360. So as you're obtaining gear, be sure you're keeping an eye on those with max power, and know that anything you fall in love with at 1060 will be below the base power next season. This does go for weapons and armor. Bungie did make it possible for you to reobtain old armor with the new power rank, however, so as you're decrypting Umbral Engrams or playing missions, be sure you're checking the power. Regardless of how you feel about this system, I'm just telling you how it's going to work going forward. Okay, let's say you're a PvP player. There are a lot of options for you to play around in. There's a glory playlist that'll put your skill to the test and pit you against other players at your skill level. This also gives you double drops because you're ranking up your glory and your core level at the same time. So it's a fairly efficient way to level up. In addition, you're getting blues at the same time. All other playlists do not take skill into account anymore and instead queue you with other players with a better connection. This means you should get into matches faster if you're playing casual, but there are still several avenues for you to test your skill. One of those options is Trials of Osiris.
Welcome to the Trials of Saint 14. Ha! A joke.
They brought back the very popular 3v3 mode, and while the PC version has been dealing with hackers ruining the experience, the console side of things does a better job of retaining that original feel. Unless someone wears Anateus wards. Ugh. So going over a few of the other modes really fast. Strikes haven't changed much. Just be sure you grab some bounties before doing them so you can get some XP on your season pass if you've picked it up. Gambit is still a split between normal Gambit and Gambit Prime for now. You'll want to fight through waves of enemies, turn in the motes, kill the envoys, and then kill the big boss. Both modes are basically the same except in Gambit Prime, you have to kill envoys a few more times. Now if you've been gone a really long time, you might not know about the Artifact. The Artifact is a new device that allows you to infinitely level as you get XP. It gives you a bonus power above your base power. It also has some important mods you'll want to acquire. Barrier, Overload, and Unstoppable mods should be acquired so you can take on the new champion enemies in the game. Just be sure you have at least one of each and that you unlock the one for the weapon type that you prefer to use. There is one more thing I want to touch on, however, and that's the dungeons. If you manage to get powered enough to take these on, I highly recommend trying them out with your friends. They have some really cool mechanics, and having done each without looking, you can figure them out fairly quick. Of course, don't be afraid to look up a guide if you just want to get through them. The best part? They reward pinnacle gear that also has a high stat roll. Yes. Currently, there's the Shattered Throne, a 750 power level dungeon, Pit of Heresy, a 940 power level dungeon on the moon, and Prophecy, a 1040 level dungeon found in the tower. So that's the long and the short of what you probably need to know to be caught up in the world of Destiny. Again, if it seems like a lot, feel free to ask me to elaborate on a point in the description below. Remember that all of this is optional. You can just play casually and enjoy the story missions at your leisure, or PvP, or whatever mode you prefer, or you can jump into the advanced activities. The choice is yours. Regardless, I hope that helps get you started.
So to recap, if you're below 1010, you can really do anything. Play through the campaigns to level up. Most will take you to a much higher level by the end of the main campaign. You can also do any activity, and just be sure to constantly keep the highest power item on, or at least in your inventory. After 10-10, start by doing your powerful Tier 1, then Tier 2, then Tier 3 activities to get your initial power boost. Also, be sure you're always picking up bounties as you do this. After your powerfuls, you can do pinnacle activities. These are missions like dungeons, raids, and now include your Gambit and Vanguard Strike weekly progress. If you have the season pass, you'll also get an artifact once you do the first story mission. This will allow you to get additional bonus power levels in the season. Have fun. You don't need to worry too much. Just playing casually will help you level up. So pick something you enjoy and just have fun. Thank you. And until next time, this is Destin signing off.
We can come back for them when you're ready. Let's get you home.